This video is about interpreting speed time graphs. The worked example shows a speed time or velocity time graph of the ride profile of a cyclist when he leaves his home. Velocity equals speed in a certain direction. The velocity on this graph is all positive, so we know the cyclist is moving away from his home, and he does not turn around a curve. We will work through each part of this question step by step. Part A. Describe the motion of the cyclist between E and F for one mark. Hence, the answer will require a description of one property only. Draw lines on the graph from E to the vertical and horizontal axis so it is easier to see that the speed decreases from E to F. So the cyclist's speed or velocity decreases, which is also known as deceleration. One mark. The steeper the gradient of the line on a velocity time graph, then the greater the acceleration or deceleration. Part B asks, what letters on the graph the cyclist will be stationary? Also, for one mark, look at the graph carefully. Sections B and C and D and E are horizontal lines. On a speed time graph, horizontal lines mean the cyclist travels at a constant speed. So the only times when the cyclist has stopped are at the start and end of the motion, where the speed is equal to zero at the bottom of the vertical axis. So A and F are the only letters where the cyclist is stationary. One mark. We can see immediately that part C is going to be harder, as it requires a calculation and is worth 3 marks. Calculate the distance travelled between D and F. Remember that speed is equal to distance divided by time. So distance is equal to speed times time. How do we use the graph to calculate distance? Look at the axis on the graph. The vertical axis is speed, and the horizontal axis is time. This is equal to the area under the graph. For a speed or velocity time graph, the area underneath is equal to the distance travelled. One mark. Here, this area is made up of a rectangle and a triangle. The area of the rectangle is 20, which is the height, times 10, which is the width, which is equal to 200 metres. The area of the triangle is a half times base of 5 times height of 20. This is equal to 50 metres. For the second mark, add the two areas together to obtain the total distance travelled between D and F. This is equal to 200 plus 50, which equals 250 metres for the final mark. Part D says to calculate the acceleration of the cyclist between C and D for 2 marks. We should immediately recognise that acceleration is the rate of change of speed, which equals the rate of change of the slope, which equals the gradient of the speed time graph. Acceleration is equal to rise over run. On a speed time graph, this equals the change in speed divided by time, which equals 20 minus 10 divided by 25 minus 20 for 1 mark. This equals 10 divided by 5, which equals 2 meters per second squared for the final mark. It is good practice to use the entire length of the line to calculate the gradient. Part E asks to describe the motion of the cyclist between A and B. This is the most difficult part of the question. The gradient of a speed time graph represents the acceleration. Acceleration equals change in speed divided by time. By drawing a tangent to the curve at the bottom and at the top, it is possible to see that the gradient of the curve increases. This means that the acceleration increases between A and B. The 2 marks are awarded for increasing and acceleration. Draw 2 tangents to the curve to identify how the gradient changes. In summary, the gradient of a speed time or velocity time graph represents acceleration because acceleration equals the change in speed divided by time, and acceleration is equal to the rise divided by the run. The area under a speed or velocity time graph represents distance, because distance is equal to speed times time. This is equal to the vertical axis times the horizontal axis. The total distance of a journey can be calculated by finding the area of each shape or section of the graph and adding them together. Constant speed is represented by a horizontal line on a speed or velocity time graph. A stationary object has a velocity of zero on a speed time graph. Don't forget to check out all our other fantastic revision resources here at Save My Exams.